and welcome on board Slot Hoarding Airlines. Please pay attention to our safety video, which will tell you what to do in case of sudden cancellation.
Today, the government is announcing some changes to the demand management system here at Sydney Airport. The first thing we're about to do is an audit of the slots so that we make sure there isn't any slot hoarding and that there are appropriate penalties if there is.
Recently, the major airlines have come under fire for
slot hoarding,
accused of hogging Sydney Airport's limited number of takeoff and landing times, more than they had the capacity to run, then cancelling at the last minute.
In a nutshell, they do it to keep competition out. If they can retain more slots than other airlines have, they're more likely to shut potential rivals out of Sydney Airport, which is a very important airport for the Australian network.
Qantas and Virgin deny they engage in slot hoarding.
Qantas welcomes reforms to the slot management system.
It's a step in the right direction to improving efficiency and competition at Sydney Airport.
Due to nearby population density, Sydney Airport restricts takeoffs and landings to 80 per hour, which means slots are limited. If any airline fails to run at least 80% of its schedule, it risks losing its slots. But there are workarounds.
They can get around that by moving a flight, say a 7 a.m. flight to 7:30, and then cancelling it to work the system.
With cancellation rates on Sydney routes as high as 15%, critics say the 80-20 rule is too lenient, but
we're not making changes to that at all.
What they will do is increase transparency, with airlines required to publicly provide their reasons for cancelling or delaying a flight.
No, the slots are not your property. They are the Australian travelling public's property.
It's a really positive development because the airlines themselves have been insisting that they're not gaming the system, and this will show for once and for all whether or not they actually are.
Thank you for your attention. We hope you have a pleasant flight, at least 80% of the time.
Tim Jordan is the CEO of Bonza, and he's found time to slot us in. Tim, do you think this will work?
Let's see. I will believe that it works when we have big purple aircraft showing up in Sydney, delivering lower costs, lower airfares to Sydney siders and for the rest of the country to get into Sydney. Then I will believe it.
Is it at least a good start?
I think yes. From the announcement today, it's encouraging. The phrase I want to use, it sounds a bit like a politician, but so don't hold that against me, but I'm cautiously optimistic that we're on the right path.
Now, Tim, what reforms would you like to see? What's on your wish list?
I think the transparency element of this is very important. So making sure that people aren't or companies are not rorting the system. I think it has been open to rorting and companies have taken advantage. The ACCC themselves have called out this issue just last week. So I think we need to close those loopholes. I think introducing more flexibility for the slots that are there is a good move as well. So we are encouraged by this announcement today. I think, as is always the case, the devil is in the detail and in the execution.
So, Tim, you used to work at Virgin Blue. Was slot hoarding something that was discussed there? Did people refer to it? Was it euphemistic the way they discussed it, or just not at all?
I was at Virgin Blue about 20 years ago. That was a time when Virgin had to fight very hard to actually get access to the terminal space in Sydney. So we were operating out of prefabs as a terminal in Sydney. So I think we have been here before, and I think we do realise that competition is a really good thing. Aviation is just about the most concentrated business sector in Australia. 93% of the sector is controlled by two companies. That isn't good. That isn't good for the consumer. And the sooner that we encourage more competition in the sector, the better. And Bonza is part of that solution, especially for the Sydney Basin.
Okay, now, Tim Jordan, I like the name Bonza. I think you've done well with it. Love the little thumbs up for the B. Great stuff, right? But did you ever consider calling your company Air Jordan?
Slam dunk, Sammy.
Thank you.
Strangely enough, no. We did at one point think about calling it Cooey, but Bonza we actually went for Yeah, but Bonza is where we landed, and we like Bonza. So, yeah, but no Air Jordan, no, absolutely not.
Okay, got an option for your next job.
Yeah.
There you go. Just sorts it out. Tim, thank you very much for speaking to us.
Thanks.